What's up, guys? Welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we aim to teach you everything to do with live streaming and to do with content creation within the gaming niche. Now, are you finding it hard to stand out on Twitch amongst the tens of thousands of other streamers trying to stand out there? Maybe you think, is there a better platform to be streaming to as a beginner streamer or as a streamer trying to get noticed? You may know that there's plenty of other platforms that now want to promote your live stream, but which one to stream to? Well, in today's video, we are going to be looking at a service called Restream, which allows you to stream to Twitch, Mixer, Facebook, YouTube Gaming, Smashcast, and over 30 other platforms all at the same time, all without any additional bandwidth or performance hits on your PC, and all completely for free. So, sounds good? Let's dive in. So before we hop onto the computer and take a look at Restream, I think it's important to discuss what I think the benefits are of using a service like Restream. And the first and most obvious one is that it multiplies the platforms that you're on. So not only have you got a chance of getting discovered on Twitch, but if you're streaming to other platforms as well, there are people that are using those sites and they may discover you there. So you're obviously multiplying your audience because you're on more platforms, so you're more easy to discover. Now, maybe 1 or 2 years ago, Twitch was really the only platform where you could stream with the hopes of making it your career. But recently, a lot of other companies have been getting involved. Obviously, you've got Google, who owns YouTube. You've got Microsoft, who owns Beam. You've got Facebook, you've got Twitter. They're all getting into the live stream scene, and they all want to help promote your stream. So it's worth considering platforms other than Twitch nowadays. Now, add on to that that Twitch is probably the hardest platform to get started on, just because there's so many streamers battling to try and get viewers, whereas services like YouTube Gaming have less people streaming to it, so there's more chance for you getting discovered. Also, YouTube just announced that YouTube Gaming and YouTube, their subscriptions are going to be combined, so people that subscribe to you on YouTube Gaming, your videos are going to appear in their YouTube feed and vice versa. So this is good news for people that are streaming to platforms like YouTube Gaming. And that is really why I think that Restream is such a great service, because you don't need to know which platform is best for you, because you can stream to all of them at the same time, and then over time you can start to understand where your audience lives and which platform is best for you to stream to. Now, you might be thinking that Restream, that sounds great, but how on earth am I meant to monitor chat from, you know, Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, Beam, all of these different platforms that I want to stream to all at the same time? And thankfully, Restream has thought of a solution for that as well. They've built an app that pulls all of these streams that you're streaming to, all the chat, into one window. So we'll cover that later in the video, but let's dive into the Restream software. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is to head over to restream.io and sign up for an account. All that you need to do is input a username, an email, and a password. I've already created mine, so I'm just going to log in instead. But once you have created an account, you maybe have to click a link in an email just to confirm that that is your email. But you should log in and arrive at the dashboard. Now, the dashboard shows all the different platforms and the channels that you've connected to Restream. Since this is a brand new account, we haven't yet connected any platforms. So if we click on Add Channel, we will open up the options for all the different platforms that we can stream to with Restream. As you can see here, there is a lot of choice. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to connect my Twitch, my YouTube, and my Mixer accounts. Each time that you select a platform to connect, you will need to log into that platform and authorize Restream to be able to access some of your information. The process here has been designed to be super simple, which I absolutely love. It makes it so easy for you to add as many platforms as you desire. It's worth noting here that if you want to stream to two different accounts from the same streaming platform, so two separate Twitch accounts, for example, then you will need to purchase the doubling package from Restream. If you just want to stream to one account from each platform, you can stream to all 30 different platforms completely for free. Each time you add a platform successfully, you should see it show up in your dashboard. There's an option to turn each channel on and off, so if you want to not stream to one of your accounts one day, you can quite easily turn it off here before you start streaming. You can also click this little cog icon and go into the edit settings, which allows you to choose which Twitch server to stream to and, you know, edit your display name. I'd recommend leaving the server on auto detect, as this is no longer the server that is best for your connection between your computer and Twitch, but this is the server that is best for the connection between Restream server and Twitch's server. Underneath each channel name, you also have a little status which shows if you are offline, connecting, or online to each platform. Once you've successfully added all the platforms that you want to stream to, we can start setting up OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS for streaming to Restream. Remember, how this works is that we send our stream data from OBS or Streamlabs OBS to a Restream server. Restream then takes this data and sends it on to our individual streaming platforms. Over on the right-hand side of your dashboard, we first need to set up which Restream server we will be sending our stream to. There's a little drop-down which gives you all the different server locations that Restream has servers in. Choose the option here which is nearest to you geographically. There's also an option here to run a quick speed test, which basically just pings all the servers from your location and gives you the result in milliseconds. Now, I know that's not the greatest or most thorough connection test, but still it's better than nothing. You want to choose the server with the lowest ping. Next, we are given our stream key. Now, exactly like Twitch or YouTube or any of the other services, you should keep this key completely private, as it's the only thing that's required for somebody else to stream to all of your accounts. If for some reason you share it with somebody, like I'm doing in this video, you can of course reset it by clicking this little refresh icon here. Select the whole stream key and copy it. Then we'll head into our streaming software. I'm going to show both OBS and Streamlabs OBS quickly since they're exactly the same. So we start by going to Settings, then the Stream tab, and under Service we will select Restream.io. For the server, we're going to choose the same server that we just selected in the dashboard, and then finally we are going to paste in our stream key. In SLOBS, it's the exact same process. Go to Settings, Stream, select Restream.io, choose the server, and paste the stream key. One final thing that we need to do if you're using OBS or Streamlabs OBS is to fix a little issue which currently exists that one of the Restream engineers has told me about for best results. So go back into your settings and select the Output tab. If your current output mode is set to Simple, we need to make a quick note of these two settings here, our bitrate and our encoder. Now we can change the output mode to Advanced, as we need to disable an option in here. First, let's set our encoder and our bitrate back to what we just noted down from the Simple tab. Next, we want to uncheck this box, Enforce Streaming Service Encoder Settings. We'll then set our keyframe interval to 2 and change our profile to Main. I know this sounds complex and I haven't really explained what these settings do, but it's just really an issue with how OBS and Streamlabs OBS are enforcing the Restream encoder settings wrongly. Just to reiterate, I'll do it in Streamlabs OBS as well. Go to Settings, to the Output tab, change to Advanced, uncheck this box, set this to 2, and set this to Main, and then make sure that our encoder and our bitrate are the same as what they were when we were on the Simple Output mode. Now, technically, we have done everything that we need to do to go live on multiple platforms using Restream, but there are a couple of other features I want to talk about before we do. Back on the Restream website, the Titles tab, this just allows you to change the title and the game of all your connected stream channels. So here I can enter a single title that I want to show as my stream title across all my connected platforms, and then of course I can go into each account and edit the game that I'm playing if I want to. The Social Alerts tab, this just allows you to post a tweet and a status to your Twitter and your Facebook pages whenever you go live, which is pretty handy. The Monitor tab is a really useful tool that allows you to monitor your streams as they are happening in real time. And I know if you go to your Monitor tab right now, since we're not streaming, it won't show anything, but I'm going to show you some data from when I streamed earlier. Here you can look at your live incoming stream data, so you can see exactly what bitrate, what resolution, what frame rate you're sending to Restream, as well as things like drop frames. The graphs below are super useful in diagnosing any issues that you're having with your streams, similarly to how I showed you guys the Twitch Inspector video. I could go into absolutely loads of detail here about how you can analyze these graphs and fix stream issues, but I'll probably save that for another more advanced video. So if you guys want to see that, do just let me know down in the comments. As well as looking at your incoming stream data, the data that you are sending from OBS or Streamlabs OBS to Restream, you can also click across and look at the outgoing streams that Restream is sending out to the individual platforms live in real time. Again, here we can see useful data like bitrate, as well as things like if Restream has ever had to reconnect to the service. The final tab that we will look at is the Chat tab. Now, as I said earlier, this is Restream's solution for gathering all of your chat windows from all the different platforms that you're going to be streaming to into one. This way, you can make sure that you don't miss any viewers who are chatting to you, and you can interact with them back no matter which streaming platform they are watching on. Restream have also made it incredibly easy to include this multi-chat window into your stream with OBS or Streamlabs OBS. So if you want your viewers to be able to see, you know, the chat that's coming from all your different streaming platforms, you can include it quite easily. There are two different options for the chat application. There's a web chat version that runs in your browser, or there's an application that you can download for PC or for Mac. Firstly, we'll look at the web chat version. You can see here it shows you a preview of what your chat will look like, along with some example messages from multiple platforms. Each message will show an icon of the platform, the chatting user's username on that platform, as well as their message and the time of the message. On the right here, you can change the theme between a few different options, so have a play around and see which one you like the look of. Next, you can change if you want new messages to show at the bottom or at the top of the chat window. You also have a couple of options here to alter the opacity of both the message background and the chat background as a whole. And you can change exactly how large the text and the chat window is by adjusting the scale here. Finally, you can choose to hide messages after a number of seconds. So this is useful if you are a newer streamer, or maybe you're just a streamer that is trying your hardest to grow and you don't have that much chat interaction going on. You don't want people's messages to stay up on your stream for multiple seconds. So you can set a timer here for how long they should show for before they're hidden. At the very top, you'll also have a long link that you can use in OBS or Streamlabs OBS as a browser source to have your chat as a source that you can display on your stream. But we'll be covering that once we've downloaded the Windows application. Now, although the web chat is awesome, the downloadable application has quite a few more features, many of which we won't have time to go into in this video, but I'd still recommend that if you're going to be streaming with Restream often, you should download and install the standalone chat application. Once it has installed, it should allow you to log into your Restream account. So log in and it should look a little like this. Now up in the top left corner, it should show the number of platforms that your chat is currently connected to, as well as the number of users in all of the combined channels. If you click anywhere in the top left here, it will show you all of your chats, their current connection status, and how many users are watching on that channel. Now, before we dive into the settings of this chat app, let's just have a look at the chat in action. So I'm going to open up my browser and open up my Twitch, my YouTube, and my Mixer chats, and then type some example messages to see them appear in the Restream chat window. As you can see, all the chats from the platforms I've connected are collected into this one window, and it's super easy to interact with your chat from all the different platforms. If you click on the little cog icon up here, the settings window will open up. Now, I'm not going to go through all the settings here, but you can see that there are some cool features, things like connecting your Discord, filtering out certain words from your chat, as well as filtering out words based on the platform. You can change the actual window appearance and font sizes of the messages, the nickname and the timestamp. You can set up notifications and text-to-speech. There's an auto-replying bot. There's ways to export your chat and your viewer counters. Loads of cool features, but all of those are probably going to call for a more advanced video at a later date. But the one that I do want to quickly cover is embedding your Restream chat into your stream. Now, this is exactly the same as the web chat, but all you have to do once you've got the chat appearing as you want to, you know, play around with the appearance with these settings here on the right. Once you're happy, is you go up to the box here, copy this URL, and go into OBS or Streamlabs OBS and add a new browser source to the scene you want to show your chat on. Then paste in the URL, set the width and height to whatever you want, and click OK. You now have your multi-stream chat appearing in the stream for your viewers. It's really as easy as that. You can go back, you can change the appearance, the opacity, all those kind of things, and they will update in your streaming software. Now, if we quickly go back to our browser and test by typing in these chat windows, you should see them appearing in your stream. Now, that is everything that we need to set up to be able to use Restream. We're ready to hit start streaming in our streaming software and then head back to the Restream dashboard. Now, Restream does add about a 1 to 2 second delay to your stream, which is pretty impressive, really, considering what they are doing with all of that data. So after a few seconds, we should see that our stream preview should show, and then we should also see that our individual platforms go from offline to connecting and eventually to online, and that's it. We are now live on multiple platforms at the same time. So I just want to quickly give a little word of warning to those that are lucky enough and worked hard enough to be able to have signed an affiliate contract with Twitch or a partner contract with Twitch, because if you look through your contract, there might be a clause in there about exclusivity. And it says something like that Twitch, that you agree to stream to Twitch and that content won't appear anywhere else for something like 24 hours. So have a look through your contract, because if that is the case, then unfortunately you probably can't use a service like Restream, since technically that content is going live to multiple different platforms at the same time and not just Twitch, which is what is stated in your contract. So just a little word of warning, if you're lucky enough to have one of those contracts, be sure to make sure you're not breaking it. Well, that is it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed and learned something new from this video. If you have, please do give it a thumbs up. It helps us understand what kind of content to keep creating. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do have a look around at the YouTube channel. Gaming Careers YouTube channel has all these guides about streaming and content creation in gaming. Finally, as always, I would like to give a massive thanks to my patrons. These people here are choosing to support me over on Patreon, and they support the creation of these Gaming Careers videos. So thank you guys so much. It really is making a massive difference. And if you are considering supporting me, please do check out my Patreon. There's loads of different perks and tiers of things that you get as a return of showing your support. So if you would like to check that out, it's linked in the description. Also, as always, if you haven't yet joined our Discord, we're at nearly 300 members now. It's just an amazing place to be, where everybody is talking, asking questions, helping each other grow, networking, all those kind of things. So again, my Discord is always linked in the bottom of every video description. So if you haven't yet joined, please do. And subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.